Yes. So now we are going to deal with the poem. Okay. Now it's all about it's a very short poem, and it won't take too much of time, but it's very tough to understand also, but I'll make it much more easy. I hope so. I'm able to make it much more easy for you. It's a simple short poem, you know, yet with a deeper and larger meaning. The poet explains how an act of pity, as experiencing snow on one's body, can brighten one's day up. The message of the poem is put into words by Robert Frost. Always, always a larger significance. A little thing touches a larger thing. Always, always think about what is the bright side of it. When small things happen in life, always think the broad part of it, you know, the brighter side of it. Every small thing has got a reason. That's what I'm saying. It has significance in life. So that's what's all about the dust of snow. The way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree. Shake, you know, the birds and dogs, how they shake themselves off the thing, and it's a crow. Hemlock is a tree. Now hemlock, crow is already a bad omen. In England, crow, they don't like crows. Crow sitting on your house, a porch or your house gate and crowing in the morning, they don't like it. A crow sitting on top of your head and shitting on your body, they don't like it. Okay. Again, some people call it good luck. Something good is going to happen. A small thing happens, you know, your coat gets dirty, you're saved from an accident. Someone has pooped on your shirt, a crow has pooped on your shirt, and you're trying to clean it, you stop over, you try to take water, and you were in a hurry, and in the front there's a huge accident happened, so you got saved. So there is always a reason. We try to find out reasons, actually. And hemlock tree is a poisonous tree with small white flowers. So even if snow falls on it, you won't able to understand which is the snow and which is the flower. And the poet is Robert Frost, in a very bad mood, and he's walking. He's I want to use that last word of the poem, rude. He is in a rude today. Has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day. I rude. R-U-E-D is actually rude. Is pronounced as R-O-O-D, rude. Okay. The way a crow shook down on me. Okay. I have to read it in your book. Okay, yes. Where does this poem go? Okay. The way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree, has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rude. Okay. Rude is held in regret. He was wanting to do something, or he's thinking something in his mind which he's not able to do. It's not getting done. So his mind was disturbed with that thing, and he was walking. Try to understand. You are walking under a tree and you are very disturbed, and it's snowing also, it's cold, and don't think in the cold always people's mood will be good. So if your mind is disturbed, even if it's snow, even if it's heat, even if it's raining, your mind will be disturbed. So you are disturbed, there's something working in your brain which you are not able to think properly. So rude, I want to use that last word. So he is in that rude mood, actually. That rude mood is not rude, R-U-D-E, this is R-U-E-D, rude. That there's something in his mind working which he wanted to do, it's not happening. He's really tough, and at that time he's walking through the tree. Bad omen is the crow, and hemlock is the poisonous tree. Why is it a poisonous tree? Because hemlock tree was used, the poison was used to kill. Its flowers have got poison, or some juice has got poison, and it was used to kill Socrates. Now, who was Socrates? you will ask me again, isn't it? Now, Socrates was actually a Greek philosopher like Plato and Aristotle, who lived in Athens. He was killed. You know, Socrates was killed because he was convicted of corrupting youth of Athens in Greece and introducing strange gods to them, and had been sentenced to die by drinking poison hemlock. Okay. And Socrates uses this, his death, as a final lesson for his pupils. Then, rather than running away, when the opportunity arises, face it. Okay, so this has got a lot of thing, it's got a lot of thinking. Okay, like an unexamined life is not worth living. One thing only I know, and that is that I know nothing. I know that I am not intelligent because I know that I know nothing. That is the quote of Socrates. So we always think we know everything, but we don't know actually. So if I take it back to this poem here with the dust of snow, he's also that thing which is I am not able to do this. Why am I able to do this? I know that I can do it. That means something of that intelligence is not working. Otherwise, this hemlock tree he won't have added, because Socrates is added to this. He was a great philosopher, but he was killed by the juice of this tree. Right? Okay. It's a bad omen tree in England. People don't want to stand under it or have it, but it's there. It's grown there. So what can you do? It's a bad thing. And at that time, the crow is also sitting on the tree and it shakes itself. So when snow fall on a crow, won't cover a crow. It's going to like fall like the dew which happens. It's going to get frosted. And it falls, and he calls those drops of snow as dust, because it's very small particles, you know. And it falls on his head and shoulders. So actually we don't know what the crow was doing. It must have shaken itself, or was it feeling cold, or just readjusting its branch or something, or wanting to fly off. And it's just then that what happened, some particles of snow fell on Robert Frost. Now both the crow and the tree are a significance of sadness and gloom, just as the poet, both. He was having a terrible day, but the falling of the snow on his head, you know, he had already spent his whole day in a bad mood, and he was just at point crossing another bad luck part of crow and this hemlock tree, and suddenly this dust of snow falls on his head and he looks up and it's such a nice feeling, and his mood changed. Okay, so they give a negative thing, but that negative thing in a inauspicious way, it can bring joy, you know. Now he tries to see that nature. Oh my God, such nice this, what is this nature God has made? Suddenly he feels good. Now we, in the sense is, how can small little things can bring joy and happiness to us? One must not take things for granted and should be open, and we should accept whichever way the nature chooses to bless us. Okay. This is what is all about it. if I say it in a shorter way, the poem will go like this. As the shot, it throws a light upon the unimaginable healing power of nature and tiny things. From a bad mood to ill health, there is nothing that can be cured by nature. There's nothing. Everything can be cured by nature. The author was experienced once such a bad day when a crow's movement near a hemlock tree dusted snow upon him. The snow instantly makes him happier. His day gets a lot better. Thus, the supremacy of nature as a whole made him realize how petty his problem was. The fact that hemlock tree is poisonous, combined with the crow, with the being the indicator of doom and fear, are used in this poem as the carriers of happiness in the life of narrator is really it's ironical. The poet, these objects have tried to highlight that sometimes creatures linked with negative things in life can be the bringer of change and happiness. Being outdoors in nature with all its unpredictability can benefit anyone, anywhere, at any time. That we should not disgrace the nature, we should not go against it. All about environment, we should take care of our environment. We don't know when what is going to happen. So this is all about this poem, and I hope I was able to explain it to you. So we should get, you know, even the little bit negative things. A cat crosses our way path, we stop. But if a cat comes to us and we are patting it, we are taking care of it. Some people keep cats as pets also. Why? When it rains, nature, when it rains, we stand under the rain, it falls on our face, we feel, so even in the baddest bad mood, you know, you will feel good. When those raindrops fall on your face, oh my God, it's so soothing, it's so refreshing, isn't it? So this is what it is all about. Even small negative things can make our mood better in life. So this is all about this poem, and it's a beautiful poem. I liked it very much. So thank you so much. I was able to, it's my honor, my pleasure that I was able to explain this to you. This is my part of explanation. This is what I understand from the poem. So take care, and then I'll be posting the summary for you, and the question answers, whatever are there, I'll do it. My part, I'll show it to you, and if you like it, you can go ahead with it. Okay? Take care. Happy weekend. Enjoy your Saturday and Sunday. Have fun. Be home, be safe, respect your parents, and do whatever you want after you do your studies. See you. Bye-bye.